The best way to get web design jobs with no experience is to understand what the people who are hiring web designers are looking for. Being a good designer is not something that's easy to fake. Employers can see whether or not you're good by looking at your portfolio. A doctor, if you don't have a degree, you know, they're not going to risk you having to make an operation and killing the person. But with design, if they can see that you're good, and overall you look like a hardworking, good person, a lot of places are willing to give you a chance. You know, as a designer, they can see whether or not you're good based on your portfolio. This is going to mean that you will need to build somewhat of a portfolio. I'm not saying you need to have like 50 websites on it. I'm not saying it needs to be real jobs that you need to have been paid for. Actually, you can get experience without having a job. And one of the ways you can do that is just make projects on your own just for fun. After that, one thing that you need to realize is also that there's a lot of different ways you can get hired as a web designer. And I'm not just saying like there's a lot of ways that you can find people willing to hire you, which is true. I'm also saying that there's a lot of different types of paid work for designers. And you need to be aware that you can make a living in a career without, you know, just normal jobs. Because the companies looking for web designers are often looking for employees, but they're also often looking for subcontractors and freelancers. And you can always position yourself as a subcontractor or a freelancer. Maybe you're going to find that these options are a better fit to your personality. And that's actually how I started my career. Basically, every month, they would give me one or two freelance projects that I was going to do for them. You know, it was not like 40 hours a week necessarily, depended on how much demand they had. But, you know, if you're willing to keep like a job for like 10 hours a week just in case, and you're willing to have a variable work schedule and work when you want, work from home, being a subcontractor can be really awesome. And it's really easy to find people looking for that nowadays. But the way I recommend starting your career, if you're just starting out, is a four-step process. Number one, you learn design and a tool like Wix or Webflow. Step number two is that you want to build your basic portfolio. I recommend about three websites that you make. But a lot of times you'll realize that your websites are not as beautiful as you would like. And that's normal because you're just starting out. Right, you're not an expert yet. You know, you learned skills, you're better than most people, but you're not perfect yet. You don't have a lot of experience. What I recommend is that you just go on upwork.com and you hire a freelancer, an experienced freelancer, to help you learn from your mistakes, learn how to improve your design, and maybe he can fix some of the parts for you. Don't be afraid to do that, because first of all, it's normal that you're a beginner and you still have things to learn. And asking for help, asking for these people to help you build better things and explain to you their process is a great tool for learning. But moreover, it's going to give you a better portfolio, which is going to increase your chances of getting jobs. And the good news is that you can probably easily find freelance designers working from like Pakistan, India, Mexico, who are probably going to be willing to help you for not a lot of money. Once you're done, once you've built a basic portfolio, you can start building a resume. If you don't have a degree, having just a high school diploma or something like that in your education section of your resume maybe isn't that appealing to employers. But what I do is I added a lot of Udemy courses to that and a lot of different online courses to that. Sometimes these courses are just like 5 hours long, but their name sounds really cool. The first person who hired me, he saw my resume and he was like, wow, you know, you look like some sort of visionary or something. You're a really bright guy. Like, it's impressive that you were able to learn all of this online and like that you had like the initiative to do that and found all these things. Like, he saw me like a really intelligent tech guy because I found all these alternative ways of learning web design. And once you've built your resume, step number four is just you start applying to places. What one of my friends realized is that he started trying to find jobs, and he decided he would call all the different companies in his area but are not posting on their website or Facebook that they're looking for an employee. And so he decided to call them anyway, and oftentimes he realized they're looking for subcontractors. They're just not showing it publicly. And so he got offered a lot of jobs as a subcontractor from these companies just by contacting them. And what you can do is you can use a lot of ways to contact them. You can use Facebook Messenger oftentimes, you can use their email address, or you can call them. Alternatively, if you like the idea of working from home, you can also try getting jobs on Upwork.com or freelancing sites. They don't tend to pay very well on these sites, but it's a great way to get started, build your portfolio while getting paid. Or you can try to find freelance jobs using other methods like cold email, cold call, mechanical outreach. There's a lot of methods that you can use to find freelance jobs. And at the beginning, like, it's normal that your designs are not the best, but one of the best advice I learned in a course on freelancing that I watched when I wanted to start my career was that you don't have to be afraid at the beginning to tell people that you're a beginner. A lot of people will have empathy for you because they know it's hard at the beginning, and a lot of people are willing to give you a chance just because you're a beginner and they want to help. And in my case, and in the case of my other friend who does web design, we both told our friends on Facebook that we started our career as web designers, and I received probably like 7 people, some of them I hadn't talked to in years, that messaged me and were like, hey, either, hey, I need a website. You know, I saw that you're a web designer. Maybe we could talk. Or maybe like, hey, I have a friend who is looking for a website. Do you want me to give her your number, or things like that? So one of the things I recommend is just tell your Facebook friends, like, put your job title as web designer on your Facebook account. Just make a quick post. Like, just tell your friends, hey, I started my career as a web designer. Here's some of my portfolio. I'm looking for work right now. If you know people who might need websites, or like if people come to you telling you that they're trying to build a website or something, like, you can refer them to me. I'm going to be really happy to help, or something like that. And just that can be enough to start your career. So that's it for the framework. If you enjoyed this video, subscribe to this channel. I'm going to share with you more tips on how to start your career as a web designer in the near future. If you don't want to miss that, you can also hit the bell icon, and I'll see you in my next videos. Take care of yourself.